people, young people, all around the world, to connect them with the inspirational power of the Games, so that they are inspired to choose sport.
If you grant the Games to London, you will place in our hands the Olympic spirit. Mr. President, we will guard that spirit, we will cherish it, and we will proudly hand it on.
Choose London today, and you send a clear message to the youth of the world. The Olympic Games are for you.
Our entire government, and the main opposition parties too, are united behind this bid. It has total political support. It is the nation's bid.
Your decision today is critical. It is a decision about which bid offers the vision and sporting legacy to best promote the Olympic cause. On behalf of the youth of today, the athletes of tomorrow, and the Olympians of the future, we humbly submit the bid of London 2012.
The International Olympic Committee has the honour of announcing that the Games of the 30th Olympiad in 2012 are awarded to the city of London.
Well, it's not often at this job that you punch the air in your little chicken brace next, especially standing next to you.
We're very, very fortunate today to have an Olympian in school. Now,
Now, what an Olympian is an Olympian is an athlete who's qualified to represent Great Britain in the Olympics. Now, Andy Hart, who is just sat over there to my right, he was able to compete in the Sydney Olympics, which was in the year 2000. Now, that's probably when you were very, very small. I know some of the younger ones, you weren't even born in the year 2000. Now, to actually be an Olympian takes an incredible amount of hard work and dedication. It's not something that you just wake up and do, go for a run and decide, oh, I think I'm going to compete in the Olympics. It's something that takes years and years of dedication. Something that Andy's done from a very, very young age. He saw that he had a talent, developed a talent to the point where he was able to run for his local club, all the way up to his county, England, finally Great Britain. And he's been able to represent the Great Britain in World Championships outdoors, indoors, Commonwealth Games, the Europeans. But the pinnacle of his career, I'm sure he'll mention in a little bit, is the Olympics. To actually go and stand at the start of an Olympic race, fantastic. Years and years of dedication, as I say, it's not an overnight. Now, because of that, being an Olympian, and also the fact that Andy's a teacher, and he obviously passes all that expertise and enthusiasm onto children that he teaches. So this year, with the London 2012 game, with getting the Olympics, Andy was nominated to carry the torch. Now, there must have been thousands upon thousands upon thousands of applicants who were nominated to carry the torch for a very short period of time in this country. Andy was fortunate enough to be selected. And about a month ago, he ran down in Cheltenham, only for a short time, because you obviously it's a relay, which I'm sure you'll go into in a bit more detail in a second. But if you, I think if you ask Andy, and you'll have the opportunity to work with Andy, he's going to be taking classes today. We've had about 50, 60 people come into the dining room already holding torches, holding the torch. Proposed for us, including parents, sixth formers, everybody's been coming in. Because we're very, very lucky because he's actually brought his torch in. He'll probably describe what the torch is about, how it's designed, what it represents. But he's going to be with us all day. So if you've got a chance and you want to ask a question, please feel free to come up and ask. As I say, Andy and myself, Mr. Copeland, we will be doing groups down the field in the sports hall throughout the day to give you an experience of the Olympics. Now, just listen to what said Sebastian Coe, Lord Sebastian Coe was saying during the course of the presentation of the Olympics. He said that London wanted the Olympics to inspire children to take part in sport. If nothing more, having the torch here today has already started to inspire people. Having their picture taken with the torch, something may never happen again, part of history. So if you get the chance to see it, touch it, hold it, please do so. Because it may never occur again. Definitely not in my lifetime. Definitely not. But if you've got something there where you can take a picture of and show your grandchildren, I remember when we stood out at Gateway School on the road, and we watched the torch come by. We had Andy Hart, a British Olympian, and he let us hold the torch. And there's a picture of me holding the torch. So a fantastic opportunity today. All I can say, though, before I hand over to Andy, is take everything in today. Don't let anything pass. Take mental pictures. Because as I say, you are part of history today. And the fact that the torch is running past the school, the dance is going over to Harewood to perform that dance. I think we might be meeting the princess, is that right? So they've got that fantastic opportunity to again make a mental picture, because this may never happen. I keep saying it may never happen. It's that important. Well, I'm going to hand over to Andy now. As I said, we'll be seeing him throughout the day. Please think of questions. Please come up and ask him questions whenever you get the chance to speak to him. He's more than willing to take your questions. Okay, so Andy, over to you.
Okay, thank you, Sir Box. That was a very full and interesting introduction to me. and I'm sure you're very fascinated about me, and you want to know all about me. Basically, that's all you want to see. This is the Olympic torch. This is the Olympic torch that I held. This is the Olympic torch that I ran with for 300 metres. I didn't run very fast because I wanted to milk every moment of carrying this torch. There was, when I was carrying it, a flame coming out of here, which is part of the Olympic spirit. This was lit in Greece about 2 months ago, and this is carried throughout the country. Now, every country that gets the Olympics has the opportunity to do an Olympic relay. But this torch is by far the prettiest, probably the most expensive torch ever to be in an Olympics. And you all have a chance today to have photos over this. And if I was going to bring an Olympic medal in today, I don't think the Olympic medal would be as important as seeing this torch. It's got 8,000 holes, which indicates 8,000 torch bearers, including Jed Wood, who I am, the airport, things like that. But it is a beautiful thing, and I really hope you do be brave enough. I was thinking the diamonds, one of them was very cheeky. They came up now, we're getting another photo with it, and you'll all get an opportunity. But it is there to inspire you. I got this, which you'll see in a minute, because something that I dedicated my life to. I decided to become a runner. I was much better than Mr. Box. So I decided to become a runner and I dedicated my life to it. But everybody that holds the torch, they've got their own inspirational stories. And what we hope the Olympics does is inspire you to do something. Inspire you to change lives, change your own lives, change somebody else's life. And that's what the legacy is there to do. Do something in your life that makes you proud. Exactly like the song says. Every day you have the opportunity to do something special. And the Olympics is there as a way to try and do that. Now looking at me now, I know a lot of you are thinking there's no way running the Olympics. There is no way that thing guy ran, I'll say this now, ran in the Olympics. So I've got a video of me running. I only ran 800 metres, which is two laps of the track. It's all over with in a minute and a bit. It is a video, so you don't need to cheer me on whilst it's running. And I do very well for most of the race. I don't want to ruin the ending. Don't look on me as a failure if I don't win, but just enjoy the first part of the race.
From the remaining 7 heats, Andy Hart drawn in the 8th lane and the 2nd heat of his 800 metres, which is the first two. Two, Atungi Mana of Burundi in 3, Dave Matthews of Ireland in 4, Nakele Elebezi of Fiji in 5, Schumann of Germany in 6, Saint Gurney of Algeria in 7, and then as I said, Andy Hart drawn on the outside. He's got some very tough opposition with Saint Gurney at 143.32 just inside him, and now Schumann, there's the Algerian Saint Gurney, what a good season he's had. World number 2 on the season, on time that is, and setting almost a personal best time this season, just outside of the 143.32, as I said, but very, very talented. He's been a logging a lot of good people this season. Schumann inside him, you can just see the German in the background, the long-haired German, the reigning European senior and under-23 champion. 2 laps of the track, first two to qualify, plus the 8 fastest to the semi-finals on Monday. Andy Hart really has to go off in the early stages. He's got to establish himself in a good position to compete in this race. Atungi Mana of Burundi has a reputation of going out pretty quickly in the all-white strip, just taking the lead along with Schumann. And it's been slowed down just a little bit. Andy Hart comes in and slows it just a bit, Brendan.
Well, he talked the other day about running this race positively. Try and get him close to where, and try and stay in contention, because he's been known to drift over races and get himself, leave himself far too much to do in the later stages. Andy Hart on the outside in the blue vest of Great Britain, but right behind Andy Hart is the man that we're going to be watching through today, and then through to the semi-final, and I'm pretty sure, figure largely the final, and that is the Algerian Saeed. too early, just behind, second from the back, as they come through a fairly congested opening lap, 54.66. Well, it's going to have a hell of a jump before the line from there.
Whit Marsh, the Canadian, the Pan American, Ron Smithers from last season, and advanced through the heats of the World Championship doing well. He's leading the red strip of Canada. Next to him, Schumann, the European champion, Hart in third. And then McKay, the BC, looking on the inside. Andy Hart's got himself out of trouble, good place there. Tricky Marner moving out to make his attack. Well, this is a positive piece of running with 200 metres to go. Hart leads, Whit Marsh in second place. Then in third place is Schumann, the German. Then the side, Gurney in fourth place. Certainly Hart has made the go with it. Hart and Schumann leading at the moment, and here comes Sarkozy on the outside, and it's the first two to go through. Tricky Marner coming wide on the outside. Schumann comes through, and he's going to take the lead spot. Sarkozy takes the second spot, and Tricky Marner must wait to see whether he's a fastest qualifier, but our class showed there, Brendan, it went very much to the script, the two principals coming through comfortably.
It certainly did. It was almost an impossible task for Andy out there to try and take on Schumann, the European champion, and also Sayid Gurney, who I think is probably going to be a favourite for this race. But he did approach the race positively. 200 minutes remaining, Andy Hart's given himself every chance. When you come to the Olympic Games and you do your running as best you can, then you can't have any complaints about that. So coming into the straight, the talent was behind him. Schumann looks on the outside, sees Sayid Gurney, the Algerian, and these two just breeze past Andy Hart. And then a late finish from Atungi Mana, the Burundian athlete, who world silver medals a few years ago, but not been quite in that sort of form. But the man in second place is the man that I think is going to be the danger. Sayid Gurney of Algeria, finishing just behind Schumann, the European champion. We'll hear an awful lot more from Sayid Gurney over the next few days. I would think that was a fairly positive performance from Andy Hart. I think he did it as much as he could. There was nothing left for him.
For every 100, Kennedy used it in training, and she'll soon be able to reach that. I could see there you were calculating that all. There was a, just picking up on what you were saying at the end, Andy, about carrying the torch today being almost as good, if not better, than that particular event there. There was an article in the Times yesterday, as there is in most days at the moment, about the Olympics. And it was all about, actually, the people who have not been selected for the various Olympic squads. And it focused in particular on a girl, Kate Strong, who's not been selected for the hockey team. But actually, even though she hasn't been selected, and she was obviously disappointed, you must be, it's all about the winning and the there. But in fact, what they've done as the British hockey team is to give everybody who was in the squad initially free tickets so that they can go along and support their team. And that was a write-up in the Times because that was seen as a really positive way to treat people who had not been successful but who had been training immensely hard to get to that level. So I guess that sort of follows on from what you were saying there. And I thought this morning I was coming into assembly and I would have my moment of sitting next to, as a head, the only moment I was going to have of sitting next to Olympian, but Matt came first. And it's a good job he's a gateway's boy through and through, because I wouldn't let anybody else sit there, Matt, but you can have that moment. Brilliant. I know you're going to have a great day. There's lots in store for you today, not least going out and watching the torch come by. And they've been out there since 5 o'clock this morning, putting curtains out and preparing the village. So it is, as Mr. Box said, a piece of history that you're in the making of. So make the most of it, girls. A lot of people work very hard today to put the programme together, and I know that you're similarly going to get a lot out of that. Are there any notices before we move on to today's activities, please?